ಶ್ರೀ ಚೈತನ್ಯ ಮನೋಭೀಷ್ಟಂ ಸ್ಥಾಪಿತಂ ಯೇನ ಭೂತಲೆ ಸ್ವಯಂ ರೂಪ ಕದಾ ಮಹ್ಯಂ ದದಾತಿ ಸ್ವಪದಾಂತಿಕಂ ಮುಖಂ ಕರೋತಿ ವಾಚಾಲಂ ಪಂಗುಂ ಲಂಘಯತೆ ಗಿರಿಂ ಯತ್ಕೃಪಾ ತಮಹಂ ವಂದೇ ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರುಂ ದೀನತಾರಣಂ ಶ್ರೀ ಚೈತನ್ಯೈಶ್ವರಂ ಪರಮಾನಂದ ಮಾಧವಂ ನಮಂ ವಿಷ್ಣು ಪಾದಾಯ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಪ್ರೇಷ್ಠಾಯ ಭೂತಲೆ ಶ್ರೀಮತೆ ಭಕ್ತಿ ವೇದಾಂತ ಸ್ವಾಮಿನಿತಿ ನಾಮಿನೆ ನಮಸ್ತೆ ಸಾರಸ್ವತೆ ದೇವೆ ಗೌರವಾಣಿ ಪ್ರಚಾರಣೆ ನಿರ್ವಿಶೇಷ ಶೂನ್ಯವಾದಿ ಪಾಶ್ಚಾತ್ಯ ದೇಶ ಧಾರಣೆ. ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ಡಜಂಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಲುಕ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಯು ವೆರಿ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ ಸೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಮೀ. ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ನೋ, ನಾಟ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ವೆರಿ ವೆಲ್. ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ಗುಡ್ 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 ಗುಡ್. ನನಗೆ ಕನ್ನಡ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ, ಅದರಿಂದ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ದಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತೀನಿ. I practiced that this afternoon. Not that I know Kannada. It is my great privilege, pleasure and honor to be here this evening at Shri Kshetra Dharmasthala. And I want to express my deepest and sincerest gratitude to Shriman Dharmadhikari ji of Dharmasthala, Dr. Shri Virendra Hegde ji. What an auspicious day for me to come here. It is his birthday today and it is absolutely an auspicious meeting with him on this incredibly auspicious day. My respects to Shrimati Sumitra Mahanjan ji and all the dignitaries on the dais, and my sincere gratitude to all of you for being here this evening. Wherever I travel across the world, Indians are known for three very special characteristics. जहाँ भी मैं विश्व में भ्रमण करता हूँ, वहाँ भारतीयों की इन तीन चीजों से विशेष रूप से पहचान होती है. द फर्स्ट थिंग दैट इंडियंस आर नोन फॉर अक्रॉस द वर्ल्ड इज इंडियंस आर वेरी स्मार्ट. डू यू अग्री? ओके, थैंक यू. एंड एस्पेशली व्हेन इट कम्स टू मेकिंग मनी, इंडियंस आर स्मार्टर. एस्पेशली इफ दे आर शेट्टीज फ्रॉम मैंगलोर, दे आर स्मार्टेस्ट. Extremely smart, right? There was a class, and in the class the teacher came, 7-year-old kids, and the teacher asked the boy called Varun, Varun, what do you want to be when you grow up? Varun said, well, I want to be a multi-billionaire, crore crore pati. I want 365 cars, one for each day of the year, 25 homes, 5 chartered planes and 6 bank accounts. Teacher said, look Varun, I didn't ask you to write an essay. I asked you what you want to be. In the same class, there was another 7-year-old girl whose name was Pooja Shetty. She was from Mangalore. So teacher asked Pooja, don't write an essay like Varun, okay? Tell in 2 words what you want to be. She said, Varun's wife. I will do all, let Varun do all the earning of the money. And Pooja gets married and gets all the money. Shettys are extremely smart. But jokes apart, I know that across the world, Indians are known to be extremely sharp for their smartness. 13 of the doctors of the President of the United States of India, in the United States of America, are Indians. But that's not the only speciality, ladies and gentlemen. Number one, Indians are smart. But number two, Indians are also very much known to be sparing and saving. They save, they spare. The economy grows not by earning. The economy grows by saving. And the greatest savers of the country are the women at home. So when demonetization happened, they were in greatest anxiety because they had the greatest cash in their house and they didn't know how to reveal it to their husbands that I saved all this money. But you know how to know an Indian? An Indian person is known to be that person who after the shampoo bottle is over, will put water in it till last bubble comes out, they will not throw it. They will not throw it. Who is an Indian? An Indian person is a person who after the toothpaste is over. No, I know you don't do that extreme. But after the toothpaste is over, you'll go from back to, how many of you have done that? Going from back to front, 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 and one day it doesn't come out. How do you know an Indian? An Indian is a person who, when there is a hole in the t-shirt, he will keep it for the night. When it is not even usable in the night, he will keep it for holy colors. And when it is not even usable for holy, then he'll use it as a pocha, as a mop at home. Known for being sparing and saving, ladies and gentlemen. We are known to be smart. We are known to be sparing. And in today's world, Indians are also known for a third S. The first S, smart. The second S, sparing. And the third S, Indians also now have a great spending capacity. Today people are making so much money and are spending so much money. A phone costs 1.5 lakh rupees. Aapke dada pardada ne kabhi 1.5 lakh ka phone kharida tha? Lekin aaj to paise kharch karne ki kshamta sare rashtra mein badh gayi hai. People spend money like anything, even on weddings. You come to Mumbai. One of my friend's son, he got married. That friend spent 400 crore rupees on his wedding. सुना आपने, फिर से बताता हूं. मेरे मित्र के बेटे की शादी में मेरे मित्र ने 400 करोड़ रुपए खर्चे किए और शादी 6 महीने चली बस. एटलीस्ट इट शुड हैव लास्टेड. एटलीस्ट शुड हैव लास्टेड. बट नाउअडेज़ द स्लोगन इज लव एट फर्स्ट साइट एंड डिवोर्स एट फर्स्ट फाइट. ओ माय गॉड, आई मस्ट टेल यू. बट बिलीव मी, द स्पेंडिंग कैपेसिटी ऑफ द कंट्री हैज इंक्रीज्ड लाइक एनीथिंग. One little boy came to his father and said, "How much did your marriage cost you, Papa?" Father said, "I'm still paying, beta." You know. Now the fact of the matter is this: across the world, people are, as Indians are known for, S, smart; the second S, sparing and saving; and the third S, spending. But is this your identity? Is this my identity? Is this the identity of this country? Smart and earning, great. Sparing and saving, great. Spending and helping the economy grow, great. But is this your identity? Is this my identity? Is this the identity of this country called India? Kya kharcha karna, kamana aur bachana, kya ye Bharat ki pehchan hai? Is this the speciality? Is this the USP of this country? What is the speciality of India? Bharat ki visheshta kya hai? भारत की पहचान क्या है? आपकी पहचान क्या है? मेरी पहचान क्या है? हमारी पहचान क्या है? Every country has a USP, a speciality. Like if I ask you, what is the speciality of the Middle East? Saudi Arabia, Dubai, Sharjah, Bahrain, what is their speciality? Oil. Middle East की speciality है oil. If I ask you, what is the speciality of Japan? The speciality of Japan is its technology. When if I ask you, what is the speciality of Germany? The speciality of Germany is its punctuality. If I ask you, what is the speciality of America? The speciality of America is her liberty. That's why they have a Statue of Liberty. Har ek desh ki ek visheshta hai. Every country has a speciality. Hamari visheshta kya hai? Engineering, mathematics, scientists, technology, cricket, Bollywood, politics. Kya hai is desh ki visheshta? What is the speciality of this nation? All of these are fantastic. Technology of India is fantastic. Science of India is fantastic. Engineers going and settling in Silicon Valley. Great smart engineers, fantastic. Bollywood stars, Tollywood, Kannada cinema, fantastic. Sports, fantastic. Politics and leadership, fantastic. Is that our speciality? Har rashtra ki ek pehchan hai. Japan socho technology yaad aati hai. Middle East socho oil yaad aata hai. Germany ki baat socho punctuality yaad aati hai. Bharat ko soch ke kya yaad aata hai ji? And therefore our tourism tagline is Incredible India. Incredible India. And what is so incredible about India? The most important aspect that distinguishes us as a nation and as citizens of this nation is the fourth S, which is our spiritual wisdom. Ladies and gentlemen, हमारी विशेषता, हमारा आध्यात्म, हमारी विशेषता, हमारी धार्मिकता, हमारा विशेषता, हमारे सिद्धांत, ये हमारी विशेषता है. We go to Dubai to look at Burj Khalifa. We go to America to go to Orlando to see Disneyland. We go to probably to Munich, Germany, to go to Dachau to see the concentration camps of Hitler. सारे विश्व से लोग इस राष्ट्र में आते हैं क्या देखने? ताजमहल? जी, बहुत बढ़िया है. क्या देखने? गोवा? जी, बहुत बढ़िया है. क्या देखने? हिमालय? जी, बहुत बढ़िया है. सारे विश्व से लोग इस राष्ट्र में आते हैं. People from across the globe come to this country with one thing in mind: to seek and learn the spiritual wisdom of this country. Ladies and gentlemen, if people come to Goa for tourism, go to Rishikesh and Himalayas, you will find so many white American, Western, European, African people who have come to seek and learn the spiritual wisdom of this country. Ye हमारी विशेषता है. और अगर हम ये छोड़ देंगे, हमारी वैल्यूज, हमारी एथिक्स, हमारी इंटेग्रिटी, आवर कल्चर, आवर कैरेक्टर, इफ वी लीव ऑल ऑफ दीज, आई एम नॉट टू श्योर व्हाट इज आवर आइडेंटिटी. सो दिस इवनिंग आई थॉट आई वुड शेयर विद ऑल ऑफ यू अ कपल ऑफ थॉट्स दैट द स्पिरिचुअल विजडम ऑफ दिस कंट्री टीचर्स अस. आवर स्पिरिचुअल विजडम इज बियॉन्ड हिंदुइज्म. Our spiritual wisdom is beyond Jainism. Our spiritual wisdom is beyond Zoroastrianism. Our spiritual wisdom is beyond Christianity. Our spiritual wisdom is beyond Islam. Adhyatmikta religion nahi hoti. Spiritual wisdom is not religion. It crosses religious boundaries and it includes universal principles which can transform our lives and transform the lives of the world. And spiritual wisdom teaches us, whether you drive a BMW or you drive a Maruti Suzuki, road remains the same. ऐसा नहीं होता अभी BMW road अच्छा हो गया, जी नहीं. Whether you drive a BMW or a Maruti, the road will remain the same. Whether you speak on a Samsung phone or an iPhone, the person whom you talk to remains the same. It's not because you have an iPhone say, hello Modi ji, कैसे है? You don't say that. Whether you have a fast track watch or you have an Omega or a Rado, the time you have is exactly the same. By buying an expensive Omega, you don't get 1 second extra, ladies and gentlemen. Whether you live in a 1-bedroom apartment or you live in a 10-bedroom bungalow, the people whom you live with remain the same. It's not that you say, I've changed my house, let me change my spouse. You don't change your life partner because the home has changed. Our spiritual wisdom teaches us, our experience is not defined by the car, it is defined by the quality of our journey. Our experience is not defined by the phone, our experience is defined by the conversation we have on the phone. Our experience is not defined by the watch. Our experience is defined by how we use that time on the watch. Our experience is not defined by the 1 BHK or the 10-bedroom bungalow. Our experience is defined by the relationships that we have in that house. But we are so focused on the car that we forget the journey. We are so focused on the watch that we forget the time. We are so focused on the house that we forget the relationship. We are so focused on the phone that we forget the quality of our conversation. Materialism and modernism teaches us the art of having more. Spiritual wisdom teaches us the art of living more, and both are required. You should have and live, but if you don't live, what you have is never going to make you feel contented and happy, ladies and gentlemen. I have seen people crying in the fanciest car. I have seen people depressed in the biggest bungalows. I have seen people shouting angrily on their fanciest phones. And therefore, the contribution of this nation, India, is that spiritual wisdom which not only teaches you how to have more, but teaches you how to live more. Nobody is against having. But in the process of having, don't forget living. देवी और सज्जनों हमको दोनों के बीच में समन्वय करना है. We have to balance the two. But in the modern world, having more, that we have forgotten. I have to live to experience what I have. And which is precisely why हमारे देश की सभ्यता, संस्कृति, धर्म, अध्यात्म किसी रिलीजन का नहीं, किसी सांप्रदायिकता की बात नहीं है, हमें जीना सिखाती है. मानव जीवन में हमको जीना सीखना चाहिए. जब जीना सीखेंगे तब जाकर जीवन के अनुभव सर्वोच्च होंगे, आनंददायी होंगे, संतोषदायी होंगे. अन्यथा बस हैविंग मोर, गाड़ी में बहुत बैठ के भी रोएंगे. आप में से कितने लोगों ने हिंदी पिक्चर देखी थी दीवार? हमने भी सीन दीवार. और दीवार में एक डायलॉग था अमिताभ बच्चन और शशि कपूर के बीच में, जानते हैं? अमिताभ बच्चन शशि कपूर को कहता है, मेरे पास बंगला है, मेरे पास गाड़ी है, मेरे पास नौकर है, मेरे पास चाकर है, तेरे पास क्या है? और शशि कपूर कहता है, मेरे पास माँ है. 2019 में डायलॉग बदल गया. बंबई शहर की बात है ना, बॉम्बे का डायलॉग है. अमिताभ बच्चन कहता है, मेरे पास मर्सिडीज है, मेरे पास फरारी है, मेरे पास बीएमडब्ल्यू है, मेरे पास बेंटली है, मेरे पास लैम्बोर्गिनी है, तेरे पास क्या है? शशि कपूर कहता है, मेरे पास पार्किंग स्पेस है, क्योंकि बंबई में जी पार्किंग स्पेस नहीं मिलती हमको, बाकी सब मिल जाता है. आई टेल यू, यू कैन गेट एनीथिंग इन बॉम्बे. सो इन बॉम्बे यू आर नॉट नोन टू बी रिच फॉर द कार यू ड्राइव. यू नोन टू बी रिच फॉर, यू मस्ट हैव अ गुड कार एंड योर ओन पार्किंग स्पेस. But I must tell you this one thing. Whether this or that, we must have parking space for the wisdom of life. These principles, they'll truly transform our lives. इसीलिए मैं आपके साथ आज चार बहुत महत्वपूर्ण चीजें शेयर करना चाहता हूँ. I want to share with you four very crucial and important principles that can transform the way you live. That's dharma. That's spirituality. That is adhyatma. अब में से कितने लोग हवाई जहाज से जाते हैं, ट्रैवल करते हैं? हाउ मेनी पीपल फ्लाई ऑन एयरप्लेन? ओके. एंड हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू नो दैट द टेक ऑफ ऑफ द प्लेन इज नॉट इन योर कंट्रोल? यू कैन डू नथिंग अबाउट द टेक ऑफ ऑफ द जर्नी. आई वाज फ्लाइंग फ्रॉम मॉस्को टू कीव, रशिया टू यूक्रेन, एंड आई वाज फ्लाइंग ऑन एन एयरलाइन कॉल्ड एरोफ्लोट. व्हाट एन एयरलाइन, टफ कॉम्पिटिशन टू एयर इंडिया, बिलीव मी, अमेजिंग एयरलाइन. माई गॉड, आई केम अप ऑन बोर्ड and the air hostess told me, welcome on board sir, we guarantee take off. I said, landing madam? She said, you're man of God, right? Pray. Now believe me, take off is not in our hand. Is the landing in our hand? हवाई जहाज का उड़ान भरना अपने हाथ में नहीं होता, हवाई जहाज का नीचे उतरना अपने हाथ में नहीं होता. और जब हवाई जहाज हवा में होता है ना, तो टर्बुलेंस होती है, हिलता है हवाई जहाज. There's a lot of turbulence. The takeoff's not in our control, the landing's not in our control, and the turbulence is also not in our control. What is in our control? In our control is what we do between takeoff and landing, the choices we make. Some people go to sleep, that's the choice they make. Some people read a book, that's the choice they make. Some people eat, that's the choice they make. Some people drink, that's the choice they make. The choices we make on the plane between takeoff and landing are completely in our control. Life is like a plane journey. The takeoff of the journey is represented by the letter B or birth, and our birth is not in our control. You didn't choose your parents. Any of you chose your parents? One program, one man raised his hand. I said, "Bahar chal, baad mein milte hain. Something's wrong with you." He said, "He chose his parents." My God. Believe me, the takeoff's not in our hands. How the journey of your and my life started was not in our control at all. And how many will come from the parents, that is also not in our control. Like one couple gave birth to twins. Both were girls. So the lady asked the husband, what shall we name them? Husband said, Tara and Sitara. Twins, right? Good. Second time, again she gave birth to twins. Boys now. So the lady asked, what will we name them now? Husband said, Peter and Repeater. Third time she asked, again twins, boys, said, what will we name them now? Chhe ho gaye bhi, six, four already, two more. Husband said, Max and Climax. Fourth time, again, twins, eight now. The lady said, for heaven's sake, what will we name them now? Husband said, stop and full stop. Can't have any more. Now believe me, hand on my heart. The takeoff of the journey of our life, represented by this letter B or birth, is not in our control. And what about landing? Death? Unless you have someone depressed like the CCD chief, taking life in hands and doing emergency landing. So many students across the country are hanging themselves to death simply because they didn't get scored. Is this India? How much have we taken care of the mental health of our people in this country? We have so many programs for physical health, Arogyadan. How much have we worked on the mental health of this country that our young students, simply because they did not get good grades, hang themselves to death? Ladies and gentlemen, that gentleman emergency landed his plane. Emergency landing is called suicide. But otherwise, in the natural course of our life, we must know that the plane has to land. ऐसा कभी हुआ है जो हवाई जहाज ऊपर हुआ उड़ता ही रहा? फ्यूएल खत्म होगा तो नीचे उतरेगा. जातस्य हि ध्रुवो मृत्युर् ध्रुवम् जन्म मृतस्य च. One who is born, death is certain. If the plane has taken off, landing is certain. What stupid idea is this that we'll keep hovering in the plane? No, it doesn't happen. But the landing is also not in our control. One 65-year-old lady, she had a 25-year-old nephew. And they would always stand next to each other whenever there was a wedding in the family. Jab bhi shaadi hoti thi, dono bagal bagal. And the auntie, 65-year-old auntie, would tell the 25-year-old nephew, next is your turn, huh? Next, and 25-year-old guys don't like to be reminded, shaadi kar, shaadi kar, shaadi kar, next is your turn. 6 months later, there was a death in the family. Both went for the funeral. Both were standing right next to each other. This time, the 25-year-old nephew said, next is your turn, yeah? Now, regardless of whose turn is next, the turn must come and it is not in our control. If you are born crying, it was not your fault. If you die crying, it is entirely your fault, guys. If you are born in a family which is not as fortunate, not your fault. If you die in such misfortune, it is entirely your fault, guys. And therefore, here we have takeoff, represented by B or birth, and landing, represented by D or death. Aur har takeoff or landing ke beech mein hoti hai turbulence, which makes the plane shake. हिला देती है हवाई जहाज को. पैसेंजर्स भी हिलने लगते हैं. ग्लास गिर जाता है. ट्रे टेबल हिलने लगता है. बिटवीन बी एंड डी इन द जर्नी ऑफ लाइफ इज अनदर लेटर कॉल्ड सी. बी और डी के बीच में तो सी होता है ना जी. एंड दैट सी रिप्रेजेंट्स चैलेंजेस, प्रॉब्लम्स, इश्यूज. देवियों सज्जनों, अगर हवाई जहाज की यात्रा प्रारंभ की है तो ऐसा कभी नहीं होगा कि टर्बुलेंस नहीं आए. और अगर जीवन की यात्रा प्रारंभ की है तो ऐसा कभी नहीं होगा कि जीवन में समस्याएं, कठिनाइयां, प्रॉब्लम्स नहीं आए. चाहे वो इस्लाम हो, चाहे वो ईसाई धर्म हो, चाहे वो जिन धर्म हो, चाहे हिंदू धर्म हो, किसी भी श्रद्धा, किसी भी सांप्रदायिकता की हम बात करें, उनके सारे संतों, उनके सारे अनुयायियों को संघर्ष करना पड़ा है. जीवन की परिभाषा है संघर्ष. द नेम ऑफ द गेम ऑफ लाइफ इज वन वर्ड, स्ट्रगल. हाउ मेनी ऑफ योर प्रॉब्लम्स इन योर लाइफ? ओके, दोज ऑफ यू आर नॉट रेजिंग योर हैंड, यू एक्सपेक्ट मी टू बिलीव यू, राइट? माई गॉड, all of us have problems in our life. Okay, how many of you have health problems in your life? Okay, thank you. Health problems are still better if you are surrounded by good people. You may have the best of health, but if you have the wrong people around you, they create a bigger problem. How many of you agree? How many of you agree that people create more problem than headaches? One lady went to a doctor and the doctor said, "Madam, you came 2 months back, you said you have a headache, right? How is your headache now?" She said, "He is out of town." Because people are greater headaches than headaches. Then there is political problems, financial problems. How many of you have a loan? Thank you. How many of you don't have money? Thank you. How many of you have too much money? You don't have to raise your hand. It's okay. Oh my God, I'll tell you. This world is defined by one word. Turbulence. Problems. Devi Sajno, हमारे हाथ में न तो हवाई जहाज का उड़ान भरना होता है और नहीं हमारे हाथ में हवाई जहाज का उतरना होता है. और रही बात टर्बुलेंस की, प्रॉब्लम्स की, नहीं होता जी हमारे हाथ में. फॉर द लास्ट 29 ईयर्स आई सफर फ्रॉम अ हेल्थ प्रॉब्लम. आई हैव पेन हेयर इन माई टेम्पल्स फॉर द लास्ट 24 आवर्स अ डे, 365 डेज अ ईयर. For the last 29 years. I don't know what a pain-free life means. I have no idea. मतलब वेदना के बिना जीवन क्या होता है भूल गया मैं 29 साल में. That's how much I suffer from this pain here. And I tried everything. I tried allopathy, neuropathy, naturopathy, homeopathy, even tirupathy. Everything I tried. I tried everything that was in my control. Hasn't worked. And then I take at least about 200 flights a year in my travels. A busy year can see 300 flights a year. And then sometimes, and it's not that I go there and I'm relaxing. I get there and I have to start. Pahunch gaye shuru. And I want to definitely thank Dr. Hegde for insisting that I come here. I'm meant to be in London today at an event, but I had to change my ticket and come back yesterday only on the loving request of Dr. Hegde. And some confusion that he already spoke, but I'm glad that that confusion happened. So thank you. I landed yesterday morning from London. I had to speak at the British Parliament on the 20th. That's what I'd gone to London for, to address the British Parliament. And then I got back yesterday morning, came here, and here we are, straight away. Here we are, straight away. In the middle of this excruciating pain. That's called turbulence. I have no control. I didn't ask for it. I didn't beg for it. I've lived a clean life and I don't know why the hell this is in my head. But it's there. And you have yours. मैं अपने दर्द की बात कर रहा हूँ, आपको अपने दर्द की बात है, चाहे वो शरीर में हो, चाहे किसी व्यक्ति में हो, चाहे आपके पैसों में हो, कहीं ना कहीं किसी न किसी प्रकार का संघर्ष, वेदना, पेन हम सबके जीवन में है देवियों सज्जनों. What do you do to navigate through such turbulence and such problems? And that is the answer that our spiritual wisdom gives us. That is the answer that our Adhyatma gives us. Greater than the landing, greater than the takeoff, greater than the turbulence is your, mine, our power to choose how we feel. Choose how we feel. In that entire plane journey, there's only one thing that is in our hand, our choices. The pilot doesn't define your choices. You decide what to choose. Problems everybody has. You decide how to feel. Everybody goes through pain. Everybody goes through struggle. Everybody goes through problems. We have to decide to choose how we want to feel. Struggle and pain is automatic, ladies and gentlemen. You don't have to do anything to get it. Happiness is a choice that we have to make. Happiness doesn't happen automatically. And each one of us has the power to choose. Each one of you sitting here at Shri Kshetra Dharmasthala, come together for the Lakshadweep Utsav of the last day of Kartik, have the power choose. You can't choose your takeoff, you can't choose your landing, you can't choose your turbulence. You can choose how you feel. I am in pain, but I've chosen to smile. The smile is not going to come automatically. The only thing that will come automatically is tears, because I'm in pain. I and you have to choose. How many of you ever got angry? Kitne logo gussa hai? Achha, baki log sab sach bol rahe jinhone haath nahi uthaya nahi. Okay. And how many of you, when you get angry, you kind of speak in Sanskrit? Sorry about that. You know, when you're angry, like one lady, she asked her, one man asked his wife, when you're really angry at me, like really angry, what do you do? She said, I clean the toilet. She said, how does cleaning the toilet release your anger on me? She said, well, I clean it with your toothbrush. So next morning you have some special effects in your mouth. Oh my God. I'll tell you something. Anger is automatic. Peace is a choice you have to make. Shouting, yelling, losing temper is automatic. To shut up is a choice that you and me have to make. When we are angry, the mind starts working faster than the tongue. We don't even know what we are saying. Pata bhi nahi lagta ki kya bol rahe hain. And therefore, a very crucial aspect is, we have to know when to speak and when to shut up. Anger is automatic. Peace is a choice. Hatred is automatic. Any damned idiot can hate. It takes a gentleman to love. Ladies and gentlemen, yes, hatred is automatic. Love is a choice. Problems are automatic. Happiness is a choice. Therefore, the first thing that I want to share with all of you this evening is, choose to be happy. It's not going to happen automatically. The only thing that will happen automatically is problems. Keval swabhavik drishti se keval ek hi cheez hogi, samasya, jhagde, gussa, nafrat, yahi hota hai bas swabhavik drishti se. Love, peace, joy is a choice. Are you all with me? Make some louder noise. Are you all with me? You're not loud enough. Are you all with me, ladies and gentlemen? Okay, brilliant. Great. How many of you gone to a hospital ever? Okay. How many of you seen the patient in the ICU? Okay. And how many of you felt nervous? Mere saath aisa nahi hona chahiye. Okay. How many of you felt nervous? Mere wife ke saath aisa nahi hona chahiye. Many husbands are saying, we prayed mere wife ke saath aisa hona chahiye. I'm sorry. How many of you felt mere parents ke saath aisa nahi hona chahiye? You know, when you go to a hospital, the energy is negative. The energy is, you know why? Because every person there is worrying. Sab log chinta kar rahe hain. So everybody who's worrying has put that energy in the whole building. So you go in, you also get affected by that. Like one surgeon was operating a patient on the operating table, and instead of holding a scalpel in his hand, he was holding a garland. So patient said, sir, doctor sahab, what is the garland for? The doctor said, if the surgery is successful, it is for me. If it is a failure, it is for you. Now believe me, oh my God, every place, ladies and gentlemen, has an energy. And my second principle that I want to share with all of you, that our spiritual wisdom teaches, is choose your energy very carefully. When you go to a hospital, you're going to be affected by the energy of worry and anxiety. If you go to the stock market, you're going to be affected by the energy of money and investment, because that's a collective energy. If you go to the Lok Sabha, our previous speaker, Srimati Sumitra Mahajanji, will tell us the energy of the building at the parliament, right? Everywhere you go, you go to a temple or a mosque or a gyari or a church, there is an energy. हर जगह एक एनर्जी है और एनर्जी ईंटों से नहीं बनती, एनर्जी लोगों से बनती है. इमेजिन ए बिल्डिंग, ए हॉस्पिटल विद नो पीपल, nobody there, no patient there, will you feel worried? No, people created that energy. Imagine a stock market without investors, nobody is there, will you think about money? No, because people create that energy. Devi Usno, hum log sab energy se prabhavit hote hain kyunki hum receiving antenna bhi hai, and therefore choose your company very, very carefully. It is said that you are the average of the five people whom you spend the most time with. Choose those five people very carefully. Their energy is going to affect us, and there will be those who suck our energy or give negative energy to us, and then we are definitely going to only go down the wrong path, which is why second, choose your company very carefully. The third principle that I wanted to share with all of you is this. Sanskrit is an amazing language, because in Sanskrit even tough, strong words seem very soft. Like in Sanskrit, if you were to call someone a donkey, kisi ko gadha bolna hai. अगर किसी को गधा बोलना है संस्कृत में, तो संस्कृत में गधे को कई बार वैशाख नंदन कहते हैं. तो अगली बार किसी को डोंकी या गधा बोलना है, बोलो हे वैशाख नंदन. एंड दैट पर्सन इज गोइंग टू थिंक दैट यू आर कंपोजिंग अ पोएम ऑन हिम. नाउ डोंट ट्राई इट ऑन समवन हियर बिकॉज एवरीबडी इज हर्ड इट, बट व्हेन यू वॉक आउट ऑफ हियर समवन हुज आउट देयर से हे वैशाख नंदन, यू से ओ माय गॉड थैंक यू सर, नोबडी हैज एवर कॉल्ड मी बाय दैट नेम. Sanskrit is quite an amazing language, very euphemistic. But how do you say ice cream in... How many of you like ice cream? Oh, wow. How do you say ice cream in Sanskrit? In Sanskrit, you would say Dugdha Sharkara Yukta Heema Ghanagol Gattu. If you were to say a mango ice cream, you would say Amra Dugdha Sharkara Yukta Heema Ghanagol Gattu. By the time you place the order, the ice cream will melt away, I guess. Such a long word, because ice cream didn't exist then. But believe me, some people live by this ideology of the ice cream. Ice cream is good to eat, but bad philosophy. And what is the philosophy behind the ice cream? Enjoy your life before it melts. Ice cream pigalne se pehle maja kar lo, jeevan pigalne se pehle apni mauj kar lo, jeevan to pigalne wala hai, mauj kar lo. That's what people say, isn't it? How many of you heard that song? Har ghadi badal rahi hai roop zindagi, धूप है कहीं कहीं है छाव जिंदगी, हर पल यहाँ जी भर जियो, जो है समा कल हो ना हो, पिघलने से पहले मौज कर लो. दिस इज व्हाट मोस्ट पीपल से, लाइफ इज लाइक एन आइसक्रीम, एंजॉय इट बिफोर इट मेल्ट्स. बट दैट्स सो सेल्फिश, only thinking of selfish enjoyment. Yet there are other people who are like candles, and the philosophy behind the candle is give light to others before it melts. An ice cream melts and a candle melts, but ice cream is selfish enjoyment and candle is selfless contribution, ladies and gentlemen. And we are celebrating Lakshadeepotsava, which is about deepas, candles, lamps, where we need to move from an ice cream to a candle, from selfishness to selflessness, from taking to giving. And I must say that we are celebrating the birthday of a very powerful candle, a very powerful lamp today, ladies and gentlemen. We are celebrating the birthday of such a lamp, Dr. Virendra Hegde ji, who has been such an incredible candle, bringing light to the lives of so many, not just taking but giving. Aur dene ke liye hona bhi to chahiye na ji, you can't give unless you have. In this Lakshadeepotsava, when thousands of lamps will be lit up, all those lamps are okay, but I appeal to all of you, in this place called Shri Kshetra Dharmasthala, I appeal to all of you, let not just the lamps be there. You be one of those lamps. In your own way, give back. You and I can't be Dr. Hegde. He is him. You and I cannot be Dr. Hegde. He's a fire. He's a volcano. Lamp will be small to say he's a volcano erupting and spreading the lava of compassion all over the place. 42 lakh villagers, 4.2 million villagers taken care by him. I only have 4.2 on Facebook. I do nothing. He does the cares for all of these people, you know. And in such a volcanic eruption, hum thoda apna chota kar lete na. Hum unke jaisa de nahi sakte. If you are a student, give your notes to another one when he needs, at least. If you have a neighbor, learn the art of giving, ladies and gentlemen. And that's my third principle. Contribute. First, choose to be happy. Second, company, right company. Third, contribute. Have that character, like Sumitraji was saying, about character development, not just career development. I remember in Britain when one Swami Vivekananda was walking on the streets, one very British gentleman, I just returned from London last night, and we talk like very British people. You know what I mean, right? So one very British person came up to Swami Vivekananda and said to Swami Vivekananda, who was wearing this Indian clothes, he said, why don't you dress up like a gentleman, sir? And Swami Vivekananda replied, he said, in your country, in Britain, a tailor makes a gentleman. In our country, India, character makes a gentleman. And therefore, ladies and gentlemen, we definitely need to focus on character and integrity, which will help us contribute and give back. And here is my last principle for this evening, after which I'll summarize the whole thing so you have a takeaway when you go back from here. My last principle is here. How many of you went to school? I'm sorry. How many of you are like very good at spellings? Okay. How many of you are terribly bad of spellings? How many of you didn't care? Okay, thank you. One teacher came to a class and said to a student, which state of India are you from? He said, I'm from Himachal Pradesh, madam. She said, can you tell me the spelling? He said, I'm from Goa, actually. Who is going to spell Himachal Pradesh? Oh my God. You can have people weak in spelling. You can have people weak in pronunciation in school. Like a teacher once asked the father, told the father, sir, we are trying to teach your son how to pronounce the word electricity for the last 2 weeks. And the guy keeps saying electric kitty. The father said, what can the poor fellow do? That is his capacity, you know. Now believe me, whether you call it electricity or you call it electric kitty, when you are connected, the bulb lights up. Usko electricity boliye, usko electric kitty boliye. Jaise ye bulb ka connection power station se ho jata na ji, it lights up. So whether you call it Allah, whether you call him Ram, whether you call him Krishna, whether you call him Jehovah, whether you call him Manjunatha, like Dr. Hegde was mentioning in his referring speech earlier, kisi bhi naam se pukariye ji, बिजली चाहे इलेक्ट्रिसिटी हो या इलेक्ट्रिक किटी हो, काम तो एक ही करती है, लाइट देना. एंड देयरफॉर वेदर यू कॉल हिम दिस और दैट, व्हेन यू मेक दैट कनेक्शन, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, योर हार्ट लाइट्स अप. एंड व्हेन योर हार्ट लाइट्स अप, देयर इज कंपैशन. एवरी ट्रू पाथ ऑफ धर्म एंड स्पिरिचुअलिटी इज नोन बाय इट्स वैल्यू ऑफ ह्यूमिलिटी, its value of compassion, and its value of love, tolerance towards others. And therefore, my fourth principle is connect. Connect to a source higher than you. And with that connection, indeed, life will be transformed. So to summarize all what we have said, I want help from all of you now. Indians are known for the first three S's. The first S, thank you. The second S, the third S, but that's not our speciality, which the fourth S is, spiritual wisdom. And what does spiritual wisdom teach us? Having? No. Living? No. What does spiritual wisdom teach us? A balance of having and living. Because without living properly, what you have can never satisfy you. That balance is what our spiritual wisdom teaches us. And the four C's that I spoke to you about today are, number one, choose to be happy. Turbulence will always be there. Anger is automatic. Peace is a... Louder. Hatred is automatic. Love is a... Suffering is automatic. Happiness is a... Choice. Choose. You can't define takeoff, landing and turbulence. And choose to be happy. My second C was company. Remember, we are affected by energy. If you're going to be surrounded by people with the wrong energy, we will be affected as well. Choose that company properly. My third C, contribute. We cannot be a large volcano. We can be a tiny candle, a tiny lamp in the Lakya Deepotsava. By bringing light to someone's life, not being an ice cream only, but being a candle. And my fourth C is connect. Connect to your spiritual roots, whatever they are. Whatever you call it, electricity, electricity, doesn't matter. Whatever you call it, connect to your spiritual roots, because that is our spirituality. And with these four C's, if you have, you choose happiness, you have right company, you contribute with character, and you connect to your spiritual roots, that will give us the last C, the fifth C. Our life will be complete. I want to thank all of you very, very much for your kind attention. And I once again want to thank Dr. Hegde and the organizing team for having me over here. And I want to wish you all the very best in your journey of life and a great Dharma Sammelan for the next couple of days to come. Once again, thank you for your kind attention. Thank you very much.